I'm Jeff Myers, president of Summit Ministries. I'd like to talk about how to pray with your kids and help them learn to pray during tough times. I'll share three ways God teaches us to pray and five prayers you can teach your kids to pray starting right now. One evening, many years ago, my young son said, "Papa, I'm afraid to go to sleep because I'll have nightmares." I asked him, "Would you like for me to pray with you?" "Yeah," he said. "God," I said, using my best prayer voice, "help my son to have good dreams tonight. Help him to dream about nice things, puppies, kittens, birds." My son's eyes flew open. "Birds aren't nice," he accused. And all at once, I was struck with conviction. I wasn't praying to God. I was trying to psych my son into having nice dreams. "I've been praying all wrong," I said. "Can I start over?" He nodded. "God, I pray that you would make my son into a brave warrior for you. Make him fierce against anything that is wrong and unjust. Give him courage to face his fears, knowing that you guard him with your mighty hand. Through your mercy and strength, Father, prepare my son to be kind, a man who always looks out for the little guy. We know you answer prayer, God, and we send him off to bed with confidence tonight. In Jesus' powerful name, amen." My son slept in peace. Moreover, in the years since, he's become a trusted friend of the little guy, a brave warrior at his school. In tough times, our hearts are naturally drawn toward prayer. But how should we pray? And how do we teach our kids to be people of prayer? In my book, Unquestioned Answers, I tackle 10 Christian cliches that keep our faith at a shallow level. One cliche I explore is, "If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, then I will heal their land." It's a beautiful prayer. We hear it all of the time these days. The problem is that such a prayer treats God as if it's kind of a good luck charm given to us in the Bible, that we can force God to make things go right for us. "God, you promised," we can say. But let's look below the cliche. The Bible shows us that we don't need magical words or eloquent phrases to pray the way God wants us to. Scripture gives us three ways to pray. First, Scripture calls us to pray with confidence. The Apostle John said in 1 John 5:14, "This is the confidence that we have toward him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us." Second, Scripture calls us to pray faithfully and continually. The Apostle Paul said in Romans 12:12, "Rejoice in hope, be patient in tribulation, and be constant in prayer." Third, even when we feel that he's not hearing us, Scripture calls us to pray in faith that God will respond. John 15:7 says, "If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask whatever you wish and it will be done for you." Here are five prayers we can boldly and with certainty pray with our kids in these times and teach them to pray. First, pray that we will have wisdom. James 1:5 says, "If anyone lacks wisdom, he can ask of God." The most basic prayer is, "God, how do you see this?" Prayer is not so much that we're trying to convince God to do what we want, but to move our hearts to want what he wants. And that's what the Bible means by wisdom. Second, pray that God's kingdom will come and his will be done on earth as it is in heaven. That's from Matthew 6:10. We're asking, "God, what do you want to have happen here? Show us what you want us to do and give us the courage and the resources we need to do it." Third, pray that God will forgive our sins. 1 John 1:9 says, "God will forgive them." Sin causes us to go our own way rather than God's. It fractures our relationship with Him. Praying about sin is not necessarily thinking of every little thing we've ever done wrong, but letting go of whatever keeps us from being a great player on God's team. Fourth, pray that God will meet all our needs, Philippians 4:19. We pray that God will give us the wisdom and resources we need to thrive and to bless other people. And five, pray that the Lord will be a stronghold for the oppressed, Psalm 9:9, and that the sick will be healed, James 5:14-15. But be careful. God almost always wants us to become part of the solution. And that's okay, even if we don't feel equipped. God uses what we have right now. One thing that discourages parents and kids in prayer is when God doesn't seem to answer. Now, it's important for our kids to understand that God always answers prayer, but sometimes not in the way we would imagine. In his book, Shattered Dreams, Larry Crabb says, God is not waiting to bless us after our troubles end. He is blessing us right now, in and through those troubles. At this exact moment, he is giving us what he thinks is good. My friend Lisa went to the hospital in tremendous pain. She begged God to give her relief. Finally, the doctors figured out the problem and fixed it through surgery. One of them told her, "If you hadn't been in such pain, we wouldn't have known to keep looking, and you would have died." Prayer is our way of learning to see everything as God sees it. What God is doing, Pastor Timothy Keller has written, is what you would have asked for if you knew everything He knows. My prayer for you and your family is that you will become powerful people of prayer for such a time as this. I'm Jeff Myers, president of Summit Ministries at summit.org.